store of men of my own household. We overtook the orcs at nightfall 2 days ago.
Whew. Well, as you can see, today's wild camp is a bit far from home. And I'm so glad the sun's come out. Because driving here, it's been on and off rain. I'm currently in the Peak District. I did come here, I think, in December a few years ago, but it was way too wet and windy to wild camp. Windy, but I finally found the cave. And I walked past it originally, then I came back and saw it. A lovely cave just in there, and I have to go down here to get it. So I kind of bailed and I headed to my sister's house, and she lives about an hour and a half from here, so it's closer than it is for my home there. So I've come back and I'm hoping to wild camp in the spot tonight. I hope there's no one else there. But yeah, I'm currently at it's called the Robin Hood's Cave at Stanage Edge, and it's up. It should be somewhere in there. One of the fun things about this cave is finding it. There's like a little climb down to it, and then you're in, and there's like two kind of areas or chambers you can sleep in. So I've just got to find it. But it's not so windy, which is good. And the rain's cleared away. It's nice and quiet. I think it's going to be a really good night tonight. To find the way, and I think it's over here somewhere. Robin's Cave, not too busy. That's good to know. I made it. I'm so glad I made it in time. It's currently, what's the time? So like 9 p.m. at night, and I've been at work all day from about 6:30 through till I finished a bit early at 3, and I drove by my sister's to drop something off, and I didn't know if I'd get here before it got dark, just because with the rain going on and off, it did look quite bleak at times, but I'm so glad I made it to catch the sunset. Now I'm going to eat the rest of my pesto pasta, which I'm really hungry for, and I'm going to set up camp. I actually slept in that spot there in 2016. There's also a spot over there you can sleep in that kind of cave. I'm really content now.
I guess I'll give you a tour of where I'm sleeping tonight. So as you just saw, I ate the rest of my dinner in there. This is the view I have. So that's Hope Valley just over there. I just saw a mouse. Well, having three cats, it's a good job I'm used to those running around my bedroom. So I'll show you the two chambers that are here. So this is like the first one. It's really big. Well, I forgot my camera light, but as you can see, it's quite a big chamber. Because there's a lot of you probably sleeping here, but as it's just me, I'm going to sleep in the other chamber, which is that one. So to get in here, I'd climb down there. And you can either like climb down the face of there, or there's like a little hole you can like slip in and pop out there, which is what I did. Or I guess you could climb up that way. And there's a couple trying to find this cave. When I was walking here about an hour or so ago, I passed them on the top, and they were like, they have a big speaker and they're like blasting out music. So I kind of walked past them and I came to the cave, came down, and then I saw them walk past on the footpath down below, going that way about half an hour ago, and they've come back. And just as I was about to set up my bed, I could hear them going, "Oh, there's the cave, we need to get to it." So I'm kind of hoping they give up. I was going to have a hot chocolate before bed as well, but I can still hear the music, so I think they're going to try and climb down. So we'll see what happens. Me a nice hot chocolate before bed. It's really surprising, but it is actually 10 p.m. even though it's still really light out. Tonight's book of choice is this kind of mega volume. It's called A Ride in the Neon Sun, a Gaijin in Japan. So Gaijin means foreigner in Japanese, but it's about an English lady who decides to, I think she's trying to go to New Zealand but doesn't get there, so she ends up cycling from one end of Japan to the other. So that's what I'm reading tonight, I think, although I might just go to bed. I think that couple have gone, thankfully. I can't hear their music anymore, and hopefully they've given up. Well, good morning from my little dwelling in my cave. It's about 20 past six. I'm just about to have my Weetabix. For a second there, I thought I didn't have enough milk. Weetabix cereal is one of those ones that you need to have milk with. A few cereal you can get away with, but Weetabix you need to have milk. I think I slept okay. It's kind of one of those times where you sleep and you're not 100% if you fall into a deep sleep, you're just kind of on the edge. I know at around midnight, another group of people turned up and I could hear them. I don't think they were looking for the cave, but they were definitely passing through. And then at about 3 a.m, the wind really picked up and it was like blowing, as my friend would say, a hoolie, all the way kind of like in this kind of circle area. But then apart from that, I slept in and woke up about just gone 6 just now. It's a really nice view from where I'm sitting. So, I think I'm going to get up, brush my teeth, pack everything down, and I guess wander back to my next port of call. I'm all packed. Sunrise would have been over that rock, so I missed it. But I think it was a bit cloudy anyway, so I should probably rate where I slept. I slept in that cave behind there, and I'm probably going to give it... It's a lovely spot to camp and sleep, but I know I've had a lot better night's sleep there when I was there in 2016. I slept all the way through out like a light. So tonight, or last night, I'll probably give it 8 out of 10 just because of the people and obviously the wind picked up. But apart from that, it was a lovely spot. And now I'm gonna climb up there and head off home. Cool. Man, it's so windy. My hair's loving it. So yeah, that's my little caving wild camp in a nutshell, I guess. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. Even though it's windy, it is really peaceful in a way.